Walking through the Royal Tyrrell Museum's exhibits is like walking through a story, one that's hundreds of millions of years old. And like a lot of stories, it's divided into chapters. Timescales, like this one, divide the history of life into sections like eras and periods. We, for example, are living in the Quaternary period, which is the most recent part of the Cenozoic era. And Alberta's dinosaurs come from the late Cretaceous period, which is the last part of the Mesozoic era. Of course, those names don't necessarily mean a whole lot by themselves. So, how do we organize the history of life? These red areas on our floors represent mass extinctions. Mass extinctions can make pretty handy dividers between one geologic time and another. Most recently, the extinction that killed off the dinosaurs, except for birds, marks the end of the Cretaceous and the Mesozoic. Geologic changes can be important milestones in the history of life, too. Before the dinosaurs, Earth's continents packed together into a supercontinent that we call Pangaea. Pangaea broke up again during the early Jurassic. And separated continents allowed the evolution of a lot of diverse dinosaur groups around the world in the Jurassic and the Cretaceous. Paleontologists use index fossils found in only particular rock layers to divide up geologic time. Now, index fossils are usually things like plankton or shells, but for the rest of us, certain iconic animals stand out. For example, the Devonian period is nicknamed the Age of Fishes because fishes became very diverse and widespread. And the Permian, the last period before the Triassic and the beginning of the Age of Dinosaurs, is most famous for the mammal-like reptile Dimetrodon. Part of the reason the history of life can seem a little overwhelming is that you mostly only hear about the parts of it that happen to become famous in popular culture. You know when a book gets made into a movie but they leave out a bunch of stuff? It's a bit like that. The dinosaurs are certainly famous, but it's easy to forget just how long they lived on Earth. They were around for 160 million years. To put that in perspective, Stegosaurus, a Jurassic dinosaur, is further in time from Tyrannosaurus than Tyrannosaurus is from humans. The late Cretaceous rocks of Alberta capture around 18 million years of time. Now, there are about 20 species of horned dinosaur known in Alberta, but if you went back in time to a given Cretaceous day, you wouldn't see all 20 of them running around. Over time, some would die out, and new ones arise in their place. Another famous prehistoric time is the Pleistocene epoch of the Quaternary period. This was the Ice Age, with its mammoths and saber-toothed cats. What isn't always made clear, though, is that 63 million years went by between the extinction of the dinosaurs at the end of the Cretaceous and the beginning of the Pleistocene, and plenty of evolution went on in the space in between. The planet Earth is 4.5 billion years old, so the history of life makes for a long story. Millions or billions of years are a lot to handle for beings that might only live 80 or 100 years. Still, every chapter is fascinating, and at the Royal Tyrrell Museum, you can catch a glimpse of all of them and find one that speaks to you.